Hey guys, this is Echo Soundworks, and you're checking out a quick tip tutorial video for Logic Pro X on ADSR sounds. So in this video, we're gonna be checking out how you can speed up your automation processes in Logic X. So I was recently working in the studio with a friend, a DJ friend, DJ producer friend. He goes by Billy Beats, and he's an Ableton Live guy. I'm obviously a Logic guy, and so we were kind of joking around with, you know, why I, you know, with like basically throwing hate at either Logic or Ableton. But he did some cool stuff with automation in Live that I was super jealous about that Logic didn't have. Basically, in Live, anytime you open a plugin and you touch a parameter on it, you can just open your automation lane or a line and just it knows that that's what you're tweaking, and so it's really easy to get to. Now in Logic, it's not as easy, and I spent like a good 10-20 minutes figuring out a way to make Logic's automation a little bit quicker, and so this is a pretty cool method. It's something that I've been messing around with for, a few days, close to a week now. And I really like it. It's actually sped up the process. So I have a little demo pulled up. So it sounds like that, you get the idea. Now this is coming from Serum. So I guess I went ham on Serum for this little demo. But what we're gonna be looking at is how you can modulate different things. So the normal way would be, or automate different things rather. So the normal way that you do automation would be hit A on your keyboard and then go to Serum, and then you kind of see this and you're like, hot damn, this is a hot mess. This is insane. Like if you want to find something, it's not easy to find, right? And this is why I've always been kind of ugh about automation in Logic. It can be very tedious when you're trying to automate a synth. So even like the channel EQ, it's just this long laundry list of things. So there's different automation modes inside of Logic, and you go down here. Read is the normal one where, depending on what you choose from your automation drop-down menu here, that's what it will be doing, and then you pencil in and kind of click and drag the automation. Now, you can go to a different one. You can go to touch, which is the one we're going to be using, and it will be orange, or kind of yellowish orange or gold. Read's usually green when it's active. We're going to keep it on touch. So what I'm going to do here, we're going to go to Serum. And let's say I wanted to modulate the cutoff filter with this little envelope here. Right now, to do that the old way, I'd have to go here, go to Serum, and then find the cutoff filter, and it can be a little bit of a pain in the butt. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna play this, and we're gonna make sure we're in touch mode. And then as we play it, and hit A so we can see this. I'll zoom in a little. What we're gonna do here, because I just did that while it was playing, you'll see that it adds the automation for you. So let me undo that. So we're gonna undo that. Now watch as I do this here. We're gonna turn this down. I'm gonna hit play. Okay, so you'll notice that it has all these little bumps and kind of little nasty little things that you don't necessarily want, right? So what I'm going to do here is just hit Escape on my keyboard, or T for most of you guys who have the normal key commands to pull the tools up. I'm going to hit 3 for the eraser tool, and I'm going to go in between the anchor points, being the start and end. So I'm going to go in between that, and then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to erase, and now I have a straight line. So what happened is I spent 2 seconds to do the automation that I wanted to do, and now I didn't have to go through a list, I didn't have to do any of that. And I can do that with any parameter in the synth. Let's say I wanted to modulate the let's say I want to modulate the reverb of Serum. So let's do that now. So I'm going to play it. We're going to click on reverb, and we're going to turn the mix down for this, and we're going to modulate reverb in. All right, so I'm doing crazy shapes just to show you guys what's going on. So again, hit Escape or T. For most of you guys, it'll be T to get your tool. I'm going to get the eraser tool. And we're gonna just clean up some of these lines here. and I'm just erasing just to get more of a straight, you know, kind of a line shape that I'd want to use. So we're going to take this one down, and we're going to double click on some of these to turn it down. But now we just automated really quickly the delay. And I actually do like the performance aspect of this. I think it's kind of fun that you get to kind of do it in real time. And if you can assign it to some hardware controller they have, it's kind of fun. And then you can see your different automation lanes here by clicking on this drop-down box. You can see that we have the we did a little bit of resonance at the end. I did a little bit of the serum filter cutoff, and I did a little bit of the reverb. So if you don't want that to happen though, to continually happen. So basically, every time I touch the synth and play it, it's going to automate. So once you're done with your automation, make sure you go back to a read mode. Otherwise, every time I play the song and I go into Serum, it's going to write all these edits in for you. But it's a much quicker way to do automation in Logic Pro X. It's much more efficient to me. I just did three different types of automations. I didn't have to go through a bunch of windows and struggle to find what I did. And I like the idea of it's kind of more of a performance-based thing where I'm like, oh, it'd be really cool to modulate the cutoff filter. And I can do it in real time with a mouse or a controller and then clean up the automation. So if you guys have any questions or comments, let me know below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. As always, thank you so much for watching. I'm Echo Soundworks. I'll see you next time.